Yeah, it's been harder though. I mean, it's been harder than I thought it was, and it's harder than it was for the first 2 years. And I think in any business, and I guess that's one of the takeaways for this, is that for any business, you're gonna have, you know, points in your business, like critical points at which you've got to make a decision. You're coming to a fork in the road. You can continue to go down a path that maybe you think was right or that you have been using, but in order for you to sort of go to that next level, you've got to change something. And really it boils down to being as smart and being able to change as fast as possible. I think the lesson that we learned is that, you know, you can always start with a great business, right? You got to put out there what you think is going to work. You got to put out there, you know, the best product, the best system, whatever it is you're doing. But then you've got to really pay attention. Pay attention to your customers and listen. Yeah. And you know, I think that we were, for a little while, a few years, we were trying to force people into what we thought was the right direction. Now, it's true, you know, we were successful and our direction was good, and if you follow our system, it's going to mean that you're going to look and feel amazing. But I think there's a point at which you really need to take a hard look and listen to your customers, because, you know, they will tell you what you're doing right, but they'll also, more importantly, tell you what you're doing wrong. And you can't be that ignorant or that cocky to think that you know it all. And I think that's one of the things that I learned, was I don't know it all, and I think I thought I did.
So, and the other thing is that you can't listen to every single individual comment and try to chase every single one of those. You have to, like, listen over time, and that takes practice, exactly, so that you really see what's trending with your customers as opposed to individual issues.
Is our PM really smelling fishy, or is it just one mug? It was really smelling fishy.
Exactly. Yeah, I guess, you know, I don't want to leave you guys thinking that Tiege isn't doing great, and we've never been, you know, maybe with the exception of the first, you know, few months, 6-8 months of business where it was just, we just couldn't do anything wrong. We've never been in a better position today. We're performing better than any other time
in our company's history
right now.
But, and the reason is because we were introspective, and we did look at things and make some hard decisions and change some things that we're not comfortable to change.
Right.
And so that's just a testament to, you know, really looking at what's happening and being willing to make a move. And
So I think, if you know, just to kind of sum this up, where we were in 2016 when
hold on, the
right
lighting's bad.
March.
Move over to this one. Come here, boys. Sorry, the lighting's a little harsh right now. Okay.
Just to kind of sum this up, we've all changed and grown. You know, Aaron wanted to start a skincare company. Rob and I wanted to start. There's a problem we wanted to solve, and we've done all that. And now we've grown. We've changed and we've adapted. We've all flexed our skills. You know, Aaron's a much more successful today than he ever was. Rob's, you know, has lots more of experience in different areas in our business. I've learned what it's like to run a much bigger company. So we've just grown a lot, and that's the change between 4 years ago, basically in March, to 4 years ago now, where Tiege Hanley is.
5 years of experience nowadays.
It is crazy how time flies. But the good news is that we're all still friends. And we still genuinely like each other. I think we're at this conference, you know, the day number one, which we just ended, was all about business. And you hear some really bad, like, horror stories about partners and businesses, and we are incredibly fortunate in so many ways. But the main reason why I feel like we are fortunate is because of you guys, and the fact that you've been around and you've believed in us, and we couldn't do any of this without you. And so, just from the bottom of all of our hearts, we thank you and can never repay you, and we're trying every day to be better and make, you know, you happier and more handsome and just feel good.